हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू द लेक्चर सीरीज ऑन मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग। दीज लेक्चर्स आर रिलेटेड टू द सब्जेक्ट ऑफ इंस्पेक्शन एंड क्वालिटी कंट्रोल। इन दिस सेशन आई विल टॉक अबाउट वर्नियर कैलिपर। लेट अस सी व्हाट विल बी कवर्ड इन दिस सेशन। आई विल एक्सप्लेन द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ वर्किंग प्रिंसिपल ऑफ वर्नियर कैलिपर। Then we will identify different parts of vernier caliper. Then I will explain the concept of least count and how to find the least count of vernier caliper. I will also explain the concept of zero error. Then we will see how to measure any length using vernier caliper. Then I will talk about the precautions to be taken while using vernier caliper. And then I will talk about care and maintenance of vernier caliper. Now, vernier caliper is a measuring instrument used to measure linear internal and external dimensions. By using vernier caliper, you can measure up to an accuracy of 0.02 millimeter as compared to when you are using standard ruler, which can measure up to an accuracy of 1 millimeter. Vernier caliper was invented in year 1631 by a French mathematician, Pierre Vernier, and this instrument is named after him. Of course, there are different sizes of vernier caliper, and you can measure up to a length of 20 centimeter. Let us see what is the working principle of vernier caliper. See, its principle is that when two scales or divisions slightly different in size are used, the difference between them can be utilized to enhance the accuracy of measurement. So, my friends, vernier caliper contains two scales, and there is slight difference between the sizes of divisions of these two scales. And it is this difference that increases the accuracy of vernier caliper. Let us see the constructional features of vernier caliper. What are different parts of vernier caliper? The main parts of vernier caliper are main scale. Then we have vernier scale. Then there is a set of outside jaws. Then we have inside jaws. There's a depth rod. And then there is a lock screw. Let's see it on a diagram. This is the figure of a vernier caliper. Now, this is the main scale. And the main scale is graduated on a beam. So this entire thing is a beam, and main scale is graduated on this one. On one side, the main scale is graduated in terms of centimeter or millimeter. On this side, it is graduated in centimeter and millimeter. On the upper side, it is graduated in inches. So this is the main scale. Then we have another scale. This scale, we call it as vernier scale. The vernier scale moves on the main scale. So you can move this vernier scale, you can slide this vernier scale on the main scale. And for a specified length, this vernier scale, it has got divisions. So for a specified length, this vernier scale has the divisions, which are slightly different in size as compared to the main scale. So this is the vernier scale. Then we have got a set of outside jaws. These are the outside jaws. And whenever you want to measure any outside dimension, you use outside jaws. The workpiece is fitted between these outside jaws, and you take measurement. So these are these are the outside jaws, and these are the inside jaws. So whenever you want to have some inside measurement, for example, you want to measure the diameter of a hole, then you fit the workpiece in these jaws. So for taking any internal measurement, you are using inside jaws. And then you have a depth probe. This is the depth probe. You can extend it outside, and this depth probe is used to measure the depth of a job. In addition to these parts, we also, in most of the vernier calipers, we also have a locking screw. The position is, sometimes the position is here, or sometimes the position of the lock screw is here. The lock screw is used to lock the vernier scale on the main scale. Once the job is fitted between the outside jaws or inside jaws, once you hold the job between these jaws, after that, you lock the vernier scale on the main scale so that it doesn't move. So my friends, these are the parts of vernier caliper. Let's use an actual vernier caliper and identify the parts on the instrument. This is the main scale. On one side, it is graduated in millimeter. And on the other side, it is graduated in inches. This is the vernier scale. And we can slide this vernier scale on the main scale. So you can see that this vernier scale is sliding on the main scale. Then these are the two outside jaws. These jaws are used when we have to measure any outside dimension. So we are holding the job between these two outside jaws. And these are the inside jaws for measuring inside dimension. This is the depth probe that is used to measure the depth of any job. And then this is the locking screw. Once you hold the workpiece between these two jaws, after that, we lock the vernier scale on the main scale. So my friends, you have identified various parts of vernier caliper. And as you know, that we are using sets of jaws for holding the workpiece. Either you are using outside jaw to take external measurement, or you are using inside jaws for measuring internal dimensions, like internal diameter of a job, or you are using the depth probe to measure the depth of any object. Now, let's come to another very important aspect of vernier caliper, that is least count. What is least count? Least count is the smallest measurement that can be taken by an instrument. And in case of vernier caliper, least count is the difference between the value of smallest division on main scale and value of smallest division on vernier scale. So we can say that least count in case of vernier caliper is equal to one main scale division minus one vernier scale division. Let's try to find out the least count of a vernier caliper. Here in this figure, you can see that there is a main scale This is the main scale. And here, there is a vernier scale. Now we know that least count is equal to 1 main scale division minus 1 vernier scale division. We will find out what is the value of 1 main scale division. We will find out what is the value of 1 vernier scale division. And we will find the difference between the two values. Now here, if you see 1 main scale division, this is 1 main scale division. 1 main scale division, we can say it is 1 millimeter. 1 main scale division is equal to 1 millimeter. Okay, then we come to vernier scale division. We will find the value of 1 vernier scale division. Now here, in this figure, you see that 10 vernier scale divisions, 10 vernier scale divisions are equal to 9 main scale divisions. You can see that these 10 vernier scale divisions, they are coinciding with 9 main scale divisions. So we can say 10 vernier scale divisions is equal to 9 main scale divisions. And therefore, 1 vernier scale division will be equal to 9 by 10 main scale division. And what is 1 main scale division? Instead of 1 main scale division, I can write millimeter. So 1 vernier scale division, I can say 1 vernier scale division is equal to 9 by 10 millimeter. So we have found out that 1 main scale division is equal to 1 millimeter. And 1 vernier scale division is equal to 9 by 10 millimeter. And what is the least count? Least count is equal to 1 main scale division minus 1 vernier scale division. So here we put in the values of both main scale division and vernier scale division. 1 main scale division is equal to 1 millimeter. 1 vernier scale division is equal to 9 by 10 mm. So least count is equal to 1 minus 9 by 10, that is 1 by 10 millimeter. So least count is equal to 0.1 millimeter. In this way, you can find out the least count of any vernier caliper. Let's take one more example, how to find out the least count of a vernier caliper. Here in this figure, you can see this top scale, this is the main scale. And this bottom, on the bottom side, this scale is the vernier scale. Let us find out what is the value of 1 main scale division and 1 vernier scale division. Now, this is the main scale division. This 1 main scale division, its value is 1 millimeter. So we can say 1 main scale division is equal to 1 millimeter. All right. Then we will find out the value of 1 vernier scale division. Now, in this figure, you will see 50 vernier scale divisions. They are equal to 49 main scale divisions. Because this division, this 50th division, it is coinciding with 49th main scale division. So we can say 50 vernier scale divisions equal to 49 main scale division. And therefore, 1 vernier scale division will be equal to 49 by 50 millimeter. So 1 main scale division is equal to 1 millimeter. 1 vernier scale division is equal to 49 by 50 millimeter. And we know that least count is equal to 1 main scale division minus 1 vernier scale division. That means least count is equal to 1 mm minus 49 by 50 mm, which is equal to 1 by 50 mm. So least count is equal to 0.02 millimeter. My friends, we can also, one method of finding the least count is finding the difference between 1 main scale division and 1 vernier scale division. But in addition to that, we can also find the least count by dividing the value of one main scale division by total number of divisions on the vernier scale. So in this case, if I use this formula, in this case, value of one main scale division is 1 millimeter. The total number of divisions on the vernier scale, that is equal to 50. So I can directly say least count is equal to 1 by 50 millimeter, and that is equal to 0.02 millimeter. Let me now explain you in detail how to find the length of any job using vernier caliper. The first step is to hold the object between the lower jaws of the vernier caliper. If you have to find out external dimension, maybe you want to find out the length or external diameter, so hold the job between the lower jaws of the vernier caliper. This is the first step. Then note the reading on the main scale that lies just to the left of the vernier scale zero mark. Note the reading on the main scale that lies just to the left of the vernier scale zero mark, and this reading we call it as main scale reading. So we have to note the main scale reading. Then once you note this main scale reading, then you look for the mark on the vernier scale which coincides with a mark on the main scale. Look for the mark, look for the reading, look for the division on the vernier scale which is coinciding with any division on the main scale. So count the number of divisions up to that mark. Which division is coinciding with a main scale division? So let this division, let it be represented by N. So let this division, which is coinciding with the main scale division, let it be N. So multiply this number N with the least count of the vernier caliper. And then you can find the length of the job by the following formula. Length is equal to main scale reading plus N, and N is equal to the division on the main, the division on the vernier scale that is coinciding with main scale division. So you have to multiply this N by the least count of the vernier caliper. So length is equal to main scale reading plus N multiplied by least count. So in this way, you can find out the length of any job using vernier caliper. Let us find out the length of a job using vernier caliper. Now, in this figure, you can see this scale is the main scale. This scale is the vernier scale. And let us try to find out what is the length of a job if these readings are given. Now, first of all, let's find out the main scale reading. And to find out the main scale reading, we have to see the reading on the main scale just to the left of the zero mark on the vernier scale. So this is the zero mark on the vernier scale. And what is the value on the main scale just to its left? So we can say it is 3.5. This reading just to the left of zero mark of vernier scale, this reading is 3.5 centimeter, and 3.5 centimeter we can call it as 3.5 centimeter is equal to 35 millimeter. So main scale reading is 35 millimeter. We also find out the least count of this instrument. Least count, as I told you, least count is equal to one main scale reading divided by number of divisions on the vernier scale. Now, value of one main scale reading is 1 millimeter. The number of divisions on the vernier scale is equal to 50. So we can say least count is equal to 1 by 50, that is 0.02 millimeter. Now, another thing we have to find out the value of n. To find out the value of n, we have to see which division of the vernier scale coincides with any division on the main scale. Now, here in this figure, you can see that this 20th division of the vernier scale, that is coinciding with a division on the main scale. This reading. So, 20th division on the vernier scale, it is matching with a division on the main scale. So, therefore, value of n is equal to 20. So, my friends, we know the main scale reading, we know the least count of the instrument, and we know the value of n. So, we can find out the length of the job. So, we have seen least count of vernier caliper is equal to 0.02 millimeter. Main scale reading is equal to 3.5 centimeter, that is 35 millimeter. And 20th vernier scale division, it is coinciding with the main scale division. So n is equal to 20. And we use the formula for finding the length. Length is equal to main scale reading plus n multiplied by least count. So length is equal to 35 plus 20 multiplied by 0.02, that is equal to 35.40 millimeter. So in this way, we can find out the length of a job using a vernier caliper. Let's take one more example, how to find out the length using a vernier caliper. In this figure, you can see this is the main scale, this is the vernier scale. So if these are the readings, how we will find the length of a job? First of all, let's find out what is the least count of this instrument. Least count is given as value of one main scale division divided by number of divisions on the vernier scale. The value of one main scale division is 1 millimeter. You can see here the value of one main scale division is 1 millimeter. Number of divisions on the vernier scale, if you count the number of divisions on the vernier scale from here right up to here, if you count these number of divisions, these divisions are 50. So least count is equal to 1 divided by 50. Least count is equal to 0.02 millimeter. So we have found out the least count. Then we will find out what is the main scale reading. To find out the main scale reading, just see the value on the main scale just to the left of, zero mark on the vernier scale. This is the zero mark on the vernier scale. Just to its left, this is the reading on the main scale. This is the reading on the main scale. So this is 19 millimeter. So main scale reading is 19 millimeter. Then we have to find the value of n. To find the value of n, we have to see which vernier scale division is coinciding with any division on the main scale. And here in the figure, you can see this division on the vernier scale is coinciding with main scale division. So this is the 32nd division. 32nd division on the vernier scale is coinciding with the main scale division. So n is equal to 32. And you use the formula, length is equal to main scale division plus n multiplied by least count. So length is equal to 19 plus 32 multiplied by 0.02. That means length is equal to 19 plus 0.64. So length in this case is 19.64 millimeter. My friends, let's actually use a vernier caliper and find out the length of a job. For that, first of all, let's see what is the least count of this vernier caliper. Now, here on this main scale, one main scale division is equal to 1 millimeter. And here on the vernier scale, total number of divisions is equal to 20. Therefore, least count is equal to 1 by 20, that is least count is equal to 0.05 millimeter. So once we know what is the least count of this vernier caliper, we will take the main scale reading. For that, we will hold this workpiece whose length is to be found out between these external jaws. So once we hold this workpiece between these jaws, we tighten it by this locking screw. And now we find out what is the main scale reading. Here in this case, the main scale reading is 3 centimeter, that is 30 millimeter. And you will also note that the 10th vernier scale division is matching with a division of the vernier of the main scale. 10th vernier scale division on the vernier scale is matching with a division on the main scale. So n is equal to 10. So we know the main scale reading, we know the least count, we know the value of n. We can find out the length of this job using the formula. So my friends, by using the vernier caliper, you have seen that the least count in this case is equal to 0.05 millimeter and the main scale reading is equal to 30 millimeter. And as you have seen, that 10th vernier scale division is coinciding with the main scale division. So therefore, n, the value of n is equal to 10. So we know the main scale reading, we know the value of n, we know what is the least count of the instrument. We can use the formula for finding out length. Length is equal to main scale reading plus n multiplied by least count. So length is equal to 30 plus 10 multiplied by 0.05. So length in this case is equal to 30.50 millimeter. In this way, you can find out length, diameter, and all the dimensions up to 20 centimeter by using a vernier caliper. Only thing that you have to keep in mind is that if you have to find out outside dimension, then you use outside jaws. If you have to find inside dimensions, like diameter of a hole, then you use inside jaws. And if you have to find out the depth, then you have to use the depth probe. Now, let me also share with you a very important concept related to vernier caliper, that is error in vernier caliper. Now, if the vernier caliper is new one, then there is no problem. But with continuous use of vernier caliper, with the passage of time, an error occurs in vernier caliper, which is called zero error. So we have to actually see whether there is any zero error in the instrument or not. Now there are two types of zero error. One is called positive zero error, and the other one is called negative zero error. Now, first of all, let's see what is a zero error. Now, before actually taking the measurement, you bring the two jaws together so that the two jaws, they are in contact with each other. Now, when these jaws, they are in contact with each other, you have to see that the zero on the vernier scale matches or coincides with the zero mark on the main scale. This you have to ensure. If these two zero marks, they are matching with each other, they are coinciding with each other, then there is no zero error. Then there is no zero error. But if there is a gap between these two zeros, then there is zero error. For example, in this case, you can see that the zero mark on the vernier scale, it is to the right of the zero mark on the main scale. This zero mark is to the right as compared to this zero mark on the main scale. So if this is the situation, then we say that this is a positive zero error and we have to take a corrective action. And if the zero mark on the vernier scale is to the left of the zero mark on the main scale, then this zero error is called negative zero error. So there are two types of zero error, positive zero error and negative zero error. And we have to take corrective action in both the cases. Let's see if there is a zero error, what corrective action we can take. For example, let's take this positive zero error. Positive zero error is that in which the zero mark on the vernier scale is to the right of the zero mark on the main scale. So this is the situation. Now, here, how much is the zero error? We have to find the magnitude. We have to see which division on the vernier scale is matching with any division on the main scale. So in this case, if you see this division, the third division of vernier scale, it is matching with a division on the main scale. So the zero error is positive. So we can say zero error in this case is plus three divisions. Zero error in this case is plus three divisions. And because it is a positive zero error, you have to take a corrective action. So zero correction in this case will be minus three. Zero correction will be in negative terms. Zero correction will be minus three multiplied by least count. In this case, least count is equal to 0.1 millimeter. So zero correction will be minus three multiplied by 0.1 millimeter. So zero correction is minus 0.3 millimeter. Similarly, you can have zero correction for negative zero error. Now, my friends, a couple of things regarding the precautions to be taken while using vernier caliper. Some very important points when you are using vernier caliper. There should not be any play between the sliding jaw and the main scale. This you have to keep in mind, that there is no play between the sliding jaw, between the moving jaw and the main scale. Another very important aspect is that before taking measurement, you have to see whether there is any zero error or not. And if there is zero error in the instrument, then you have to make zero correction once you take the measurements. You have to also ensure that there is no parallax error, there is no reading error. This reading error must be avoided while taking the measurement. And while using the instrument, don't apply any undue pressure on the jaw. You handle it softly. With the soft hands, you have to hold the workpiece between the jaws. So these are the precautions that must be taken while using the vernier caliper. And about the care and maintenance of vernier caliper, one very important thing, once you have used the vernier caliper, the vernier caliper must be wiped free from dirt, chips and oil, because if it is not dirt free, it's not chips free, then there may be some error in measurement. So it must be free from dirt, chips and oil. And the vernier caliper after use, it should be set down gently in the box. You should not use any force. So you have to handle it very carefully. You have to handle it very gently. And then vernier caliper, after all, is an instrument that is used to measure some dimension. So it has to be used only as a measuring instrument. It should not be treated as a wrench or as a hammer. So my friends, in this session, I discussed with you what is the principle of vernier caliper, what are the constructional features of vernier caliper. You have identified different parts of vernier caliper. Then I explained you the concept of least count and how to find out the least count of vernier caliper. I also explained you the concept of zero error. And then I explained how to find out the length of a job using vernier caliper. I also talked about the precautions to be taken while using vernier caliper. And I also explained regarding care and maintenance of vernier caliper. In the next session, I will talk on the topic of micrometer. Thank you very much.